Hey, everybody. Today we are talking about the process. What process? Well, any process, because this will apply to whatever process you are working on. But we are talking about not the result, but the process. Stick around.
You're listening to Marketing Tips with Meliss podcast.
Welcome to Marketing Tips with Meliss podcast. And now your host, Meliss Jakubovic.
All right. Today's podcast is called Get Addicted to the Process. And I'm really excited to be talking about this because a lot of times my clients come to me ready for action and change and results. And they're all pumped and they have a lot of energy and they can't wait to make the change. So that's great. That energy is electric and that energy really builds and continues to grow. And it ripples into other areas of your business and your life when you carry on that positive excitement and energy. So of course that's wonderful, and I want everyone who wants to make a change to come to the playing field with that hype and that high vibe energy. But the issue is that if you are addicted to the result, you are attached to the result, you end up getting really stuck when the result doesn't happen. So if your goal is attached to the result, then you are missing out on the entire process. And you can apply this to really any area of your life or business. In my program, Marketing with Intention, that's my group program that I run pretty often now. I've got amazing people in my current groups. And what we're working on is increasing our revenue. So the program is about laying the foundation for all of your marketing systems so that you can fill your group programs, get those butts in the seats, and of course, increase your revenue so you can make five-figure months. A lot of my clients are making five-figure months, or so you can make more in one quarter than you made in the last two. And it's really exciting, especially if that's your goal, to make twice as much money in the next 3 months as you did in the last six. Or if your goal is to just have a viable business that can work without you being present 18 hours a day, stuck to your laptop, having no life and being a slave to your business. But if you are connected and attached to the money at the end, to have all of your programs filled, or to have really any of these goals, of course, have these goals. Having goals are amazing. And of course, that's what we're working on in my Marketing with Intention program. But my point is, if you are attached to that, to the end result, what happens is you miss out on the entire journey. And you can apply this to even like a weight loss program, right? If you are attached to losing 50 pounds, what happens when you don't lose 50 pounds? You get discouraged, you get depressed, you start questioning, what's wrong with me? Why can everyone else do this? Maybe I'm not good enough. And all of those are negative mindsets that do nothing good for you. All they do is destroy you. They break you down further. And then you feel like you can't come out of it and you can't be successful. So let's apply this to business. So let's say you join my Marketing with Intention program because you had an okay year last year and you're ready to make a huge impact, to make a humongous change, a humongous shift, and to bring in lots and lots of revenue, to make an impact by helping lots and lots of people in your health or life coaching business, or maybe in your energy healing business or your light worker business or whatever. And so you come to me with this massive goal of making four times the amount of money than you made last year. Of course, it's doable. Of course, it's doable if you put the work in. But if you are attached to that result and it doesn't happen, you don't make four times as much money. Maybe even if you just make three times as much money, but you are attached to that goal of four times as much, then you are discounting yourself. And what happens is you start feeling really bad about yourself. You start thinking, oh, maybe my services aren't really good. Maybe what I have to offer is not as amazing as I thought. Maybe I'm not really a good teacher. I'm not really a good coach. I can't really help these people. You get stuck in this negative mindset. Maybe you have some imposter syndrome, and then you don't have any clients. So when you don't have any clients, it's harder to get clients because your mindset is so low and because your wallet is so empty. So you're kind of struggling for money. And then you're in this feast and famine cycle and you can't get out of it. I mean, how many of you have gone through this before? This is so common, especially in this industry where you're helping other people solve big time problems with their life or with their relationships or with their finances or whatever. And so what happens is you don't think you're good enough, and then you can't really make that impact and make that change for your clients. So then you're not getting the testimonials, you're not getting people into your group, and you start feeling worse and worse about yourself. And then you're also struggling for money. So when you get on a sales call and you're struggling for money, of course you're attached to the result. You want to make a sale. And if you don't make a sale, you feel really crappy. And when you're on the call struggling for money, believe me, the person on the other end of the phone call can feel it. They might not know exactly, oh, this person I'm on the call with doesn't have any money, but they can feel it, whether it's consciously or subconsciously. They feel that strangling that you have, that tightness, that unease, that uncomfortability, that stress that you have around your lack, instead of that abundance. And to portray that feeling of abundance and that flow of energy, you have to be high vibing. And it's hard to be high vibing when your bank account is empty and you have no clients. So it becomes a cycle. And as you have less and less clients and less money, what happens, unfortunately, is you make less and less sales and you help less and less people. And then kaput, your program is dead. Your business is failing. You feel like a failure and you go back to the 9-to-5, or you grab a side gig, or you stress out, or you throw in the towel and get rid of your business, right? How many people can relate to this? Almost everyone I know who's an entrepreneur can relate to this. And the reason why this happens is because you are attached to the result of getting 15 people in your group program, the result of selling high ticket offers, the result of selling and closing all of your sales. Instead, you need to be addicted to the process. You need to be addicted or attached, not to the result, because when you don't get the result, it's easy to get disappointed. It's easy to feel crushed. You need to change your mindset. Don't think about the result. Think about the process. So this way you can say, if I do this process, maybe it's if I set up this marketing system and I use it consistently and apply it to my business every single day, or back to the weight loss example, if I eat right at all my meals and work out for 30 minutes a day, then that is the process. You get addicted to that process. For me, I work my business about 1.5 hours to 2 hours a day. That's it on most days. I mean, of course, I'm seeing my clients and I'm running my group programs and blah, 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 blah. But like the busy work of my business is about 1.5 hours to 2 hours a day. That's it. So I can easily separate myself from my business. I can go on vacation. I can be a guest reader in my kid's school. I could even choreograph an entire dance show, which by the way, I am doing this week and I have been working on for the last 3 months and I do every year for the last 19 years. How could I do that? I stage manage. I'm an artistic director of a massive show of 300 children. I've been doing it. It's now just a passion project. I've been doing it for years, 19 years, in addition to running my businesses, in addition to being a single mom, in addition to taking care of my dad, who's been ill for about 3 years and has gone through several surgeries. There's a lot on my plate, but I have a marketing agency that's thriving. I have clients that are making 5-figure months after working with me. I have all of my group programs filled to capacity to the point where I have to open up more group programs just to get people on the waiting list in the door, all with 2 hours of work. Why? Because I am addicted to the process and I am committed to the process. I do my power hour, which is now, because I'm growing so quickly, a 1.5 hour power hour to 2 hour power hour. So it's not a power hour, it's power hours. Powers hours, whatever. So I run my business efficiently because I have all the foundational marketing systems in place and I utilize them daily as a disciplined routine, and I am addicted to that process. So think about it. If you become addicted to the process, you become addicted to the work that you're putting in there. For example, I'm addicted to my power hour. I can't wait to get it done. I just can't wait. It's busy work. That's what it is. It's a checklist of, let me look, I think it's like 15, 20 things I have to do every single day, no matter what. Now, if I think about it as like, oh, I have to do this stupid power hour, busy work, tedious crap, of course I'm not going to enjoy it. And the result will show, because the result will not be good. But if I'm addicted to the process, and you can ask everyone in my family, they all know about my power hour. They all know that no matter what day of the week it is, I need to get it done, and it is a non-negotiable. I try to get it done before noon. In fact, I try to get it done before my kids wake up. Some days that doesn't work. Some days I put in like 15 to 30 minutes of my power hour before the kids wake up, and then my day starts, and then I'm running around, and I'm going grocery shopping and taking care of my dad. This week, I've got show, so we're in tech week, so I'm doing the tech rehearsals, and I teach dance classes, and I take yoga classes for myself, and you know, I'm all over the place, but I make sure no matter what, I get that power hour done. Maybe it's after I go grocery shopping, I come home and I work for an hour. Maybe it's right before I go to bed, I work a half hour. So if you have to split it up, that's fine. But it gets done as a non-negotiable every single day because I am addicted to the process. And if you do the work and if you continuously and consistently work the process, the results will come. Someone really awesome said this. One of my mentors said, you don't have to be good. You have to be there. Because if you aren't there, you aren't going to make a sale. And if you are there, you will get good. It's about the process, not the result. So get addicted to the process. This could be your sales process. This could be your power hour. This could be writing content. This could be following up with leads. This could be anything you want. This could be taking care of your health, you know, your mental health, your physical health, your financial health, your spiritual health. This could be reading personal development books every day. Whatever the process is, however you apply it to your life or your business, get addicted to the process. Because when you focus on the result and it's bad, you get discouraged. And when it's good, you get energy, you know, you get excitement. You get like, yay, I can't believe I made a sale. Woohoo, I'm so awesome. You know, whatever that is for you. But that energy eventually fades. It'll last for a little bit and then it fades. Why? Because let's say you made a sale and you're so excited and you're running around the house and you're jumping up and down and you're screaming, woo, I'm awesome. Yeah, I made a sale. Okay, great. You made a sale. You have some money in your pocket coming in. You're excited, of course, and congratulations to you. That's wonderful. But a week later, that money's gone and you have to get on more sales calls. And you have to close more sales or your business isn't making money. So that high energy, that excitement, those butterflies in your stomach, they're wonderful. And I want you to remember that feeling so you can bring more abundance of that feeling again and again and again. But eventually that feeling fades. And when that feeling fades, you are back at the beginning having to execute that process. So you have to celebrate the process instead of the result, and you have to continuously repeat that process consistently again and again and again because the process is what leads to the results. So back to the weight loss. You want to lose 50 pounds? Don't only get excited when you lose 50 pounds. Get excited about the journey. Get excited about prepping your meals. Get excited about eating vegetables and food from all the colors of the rainbow. Get excited about drinking lots of water every day. Get excited about getting in your awesome yoga pants and going to a workout class or even working out at home for a half hour. Get excited about the process because if you get excited about that process day in and day out and you consistently with discipline non-negotiably do that process, those results will come. And if you are only excited about the results, you are missing out on the entire journey and you will be left with disappointment. Disappointment breeds more disappointment. Lack breeds more lack. Abundance breeds more abundance. Getting excited about a process that you do again and again and again and again, eventually you will love the process. It becomes your day-to-day. It becomes your real life. It becomes your routine. You are disciplined. You are structured. You are doing the process. Those results will come. And you'll be so excited about that process that you'll want to do it again and again and again. And that's the motivation. You know, it's really interesting when someone asks me, Meliss, where do you get the motivation and the energy to do all these things? Because I do a lot of things. So right now, yes, I have the motivation and the energy to do it because I love every single thing that I do. I'm really passionate about it. I'm passionate about things. Okay, that's my personality. I'm a passionate person. But it wasn't always that way. When I was struggling for money, when my dad was really ill and I had a lot on my plate, when I was a single mom, totally lost, having no idea what to do, I wasn't motivated. I was struggling. I was having a hard time. I was struggling. So how did I overcome that? By just doing it. The motivation doesn't come from outside sources. It's not external, like Oh, motivation. It's falling on me like flurries. By the way, we had flurries today, which was amazing because we haven't had snow in 2 years. It melted within 30 minutes, but it was exciting for my kids. So think about these flurries of motivation, this external motivation falling on you. I mean, that's not real life. That doesn't happen. Motivation doesn't come from external sources. And then all of a sudden, I am motivated. It doesn't work that way. What happens is you have to be disciplined. You have to create a routine. You have to stick to it. You have to do it consistently. Whether you love it or whether you hate it, it's irrelevant. Just do it. And then, of course, work on your mindset so you start to love the process. It makes it easier to do day in and day out when you love something. When you become passionate about something, it's easy to do. When you're passionate about something, it's fun to do that work. When you hate something or you dislike something, it becomes stress. Don't make the thing you're working towards be the stress in your life. Instead, think about it as this excitement, this change, this transformation that you have the power to do for yourself. You are capable of creating this transformation. And that's where the motivation comes from internally, inside of yourself. Once you put the work in, once you're addicted to the process, once you are doing the work, then the motivation comes. Back to weight loss, because it's a great example. You want to lose 50 pounds? Are you going to get motivated when you're 50 pounds overweight? You're eating 2 bags of chips a day. You're eating a pint of ice cream every night. Oh, I have to go to the gym. Screw this. I hate this. My yoga pants don't fit. I don't like to sweat. I don't want to drive all the way to the gym. You know, that's really negative. You don't have any motivation. But let's say no matter what, you're going to get up in the morning, you're going to put on those pants and those workout clothes, you're going to drive yourself to the gym, you're going to go to that class, you're going to do it, and you're going to come home. And then a week later, after doing it every day, you start to see a little cut in your calf muscle, or you walk by the mirror and you see, oh, look at that shoulder muscle bulging. I am some hot shit. Look at me. Ooh, I look awesome, right? You start feeling amazing. So then you're motivated to continue to do it some more. Look at these awesome muscles that I have right now. Oh, I see a little oblique showing. I've never seen that before. I look amazing. I don't want to eat those potato chips. I don't want to eat a pint of ice cream every night because you see the results. That is how it works in your business. You get up, you do your power hour, you put in the work, you figure out those marketing systems that are the foundation of your business, you use them, you utilize them in your business day in and day out, no matter what. And then what happens? You start to see clients coming through the door. You start to have sales calls. You start to have leads popping out from everywhere. You start to close those sales calls. Your programs start to fill. You start making money. Your bank account is growing. Because your bank account's growing, you get to go on a vacation. You get to buy your kids things that they keep asking for, and you usually have to say no. All these things are very exciting. And you're like, yay, I get to do all these things I've always wanted to do. I'm going to keep doing my power hour. I'm going to keep doing the process. I'm going to keep utilizing these foundational marketing systems that I've built. It becomes exciting. That's where the motivation comes. Okay? Motivation does not fall from the sky. Motivation comes from you putting in the work first. It's not the chicken and the egg, which one comes first. I'm telling you which one comes first. You putting in the work and doing it consistently comes first. The motivation comes after. It follows that. So after you put in that process, after you put in the work, the motivation comes and you get more and more and more because you are attracting more abundance by being abundant. I hope this makes sense. And if you are having trouble filling your programs and getting those butts in those seats, and if you are having trouble building your business and building your bank account because you're not making 5-figure months yet, and God, you really want to, you've been in business for so long and all of your friends are doing it, how come you can't? If this is how you feel, it is time to get into my program, Marketing with Intention, because in my program, Marketing with Intention, we are creating all of the foundational marketing systems that you need to be successful, to get leads falling from the sky, getting on phone calls, making those sales, filling those programs, making money, changing your life, and being amazing and having a transformational business, a transformational wallet or bank account, which, you know, ripples. Once you have more money, you have less stress. When you have less stress, you have more opportunities. You can provide for your family or maybe your spouse or maybe your friends. Maybe you can give back. You can make a bigger impact. You can donate to charities that you weren't able to do before. So the possibilities are endless. The opportunities are endless when you make more money. And how amazing is it when you have the power to make more money that you could just snap your fingers. Today I want to make more money. I'm going to put in more work in the process. This week I don't want to make more money because I want to be hands off of my business and go lay on the beach and get a tan. Yes, please. Okay. Well, you have that power. Once you have these marketing foundational systems in place, you have the power to use them as much or as little as you need to, depending on what your schedule is that week. Okay, so if you need help with any of these things, it is time to get into my program. Stop waiting. It's 3 months. It's a mastermind. That means that if you're not happy where you are today and you join this program, you will be 1, 2, 3, 10 steps closer to your goal in 3 months from now. And if you don't join today, let's see where you are 3 months from now. And if you're in the same place from where you are today, you will be kicking yourself in the butt that you didn't join, because you have to start at some point if you want to make a change and you want those results. So if you're not happy where you are right now in your business and you really want those changes, it's time to hop on a call with me and let's have a no pressure call. Let's just talk about your business. Let's see where you are. Let's see what goals you have, and let's see if I can help you get there. So hop on a call with me. Go to go.meliss-marketing.com/MWI. That stands for Marketing with Intention. My program starts in 2 days and we only have one spot left. So you want to get on the call now, because that spot is waiting for you. It's calling your name and it's saying, hello, if you care about your business, it is time to hop on this call. All right. I hope to talk to you soon. Maybe it's your lucky day to get into my program and it's your lucky day to change your business and your life. Talk to you soon.
Thanks for listening to the Marketing Tips with Meliss podcast at www.marketingtipswithmeliss.com.
Oh, wait. Before you go, it's time to get laser focused this year and fill your group programs. My 90-day business accelerator helps coaches, healers, and holistic doctors fill their group programs so they can scale their business, freeing up their time and making them more money than they made in the previous quarter. I am only accepting a few people into this mastermind so that it stays intimate and personal. It's very results focused and also helps you grow your personal brand while quickly growing your business. The next round begins February 27th, and I've got a special thing going on that makes it really easy to join. So if you think you're ready to make more this quarter than you did the last two, visit go.meliss-marketing.com/MWI, which stands for Marketing with Intention, so we can hop on a no-pressure call and you can walk me through your business a little bit deeper, and we can make sure that I can help you reach your goals. Spaces are going quickly. go.meliss-marketing.com/MWI. Let's do this.